Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to again use the difference quotient, and this time use it on an exponential function. And again, we're looking to find the slope and the equation of a tangent line. Our exponential function that we're using today is e to the x, and our starting position, or our x value, not starting position, but our x value is set at 0 to begin. So let's figure out what our y value is. We're going to go ahead and do a basic substitution, where f of 0 is equal to e raised to the 0, and we know that any base raised to a power of 0 is 1, so that's telling us that the y value is 1. So our point of tangency is 0, 1. Alright, next we're going to use the difference quotient. So we have f prime of x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of the function with an independent variable change to x plus h minus the original function, where all of that is divided by h. Alright, and let's begin by making these substitutions. We need to take the original function, which is e to the x, and everywhere where there's an x, we need to change that to x plus h. So here we have e raised to the power of x plus h minus the original equation, which is e raised to the x power, and then we divide everything by h. Next thing we have to do is to begin some simplification. And we know from our rules of exponents that when you multiply exponents with a like base, that means you add their exponents. So e raised to the x plus h can be separated into e raised to the x times e raised to the h minus the original function e raised to the x, where all that's divided by h. And then in our next step, we're going to actually factor out the e to the x, because on this the term on the left hand side has an e to the x, the term on the right hand side also has an e to the x. So we have e to the x comes out, so our first term here is e to the h minus 1, where all of this here is over h. Alright, we're going to do another rewrite. In this rewrite, e to the x is going to come out front. We bring this e to the x out front because this e to the x does not have an h. And then we're going to take the limit as h approaches 0 of e to the h minus 1 over h. All right, this leaves us with e to the x. And here, this limit as h approaches 0 of this function, this is a special function. And by using the squeeze theorem, we know that this limit or this function approaches 1 as h approaches 0. So now we have e to the x times 1, which just gives us e to the x. So here we know that f prime of x is equal to e raised to the x. And if you notice, e to the x is a special function. When you take its derivative comes out to be itself again. All right, now we want to find the exact value of the slope when the x value is 0. So here we're going to say f prime of 0 is equal to e raised to the 0. So f prime of 0 tells me that that this here is equal to 1, because anytime we have an exponent raised to the, a base raised to the 0 power, we know that it resolves down to 1. So we know 1 is the slope. Now we're going to go back to the slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b, and we're going to do basic substitution. Here we know that y is 1. We just found m to also be 1. The x value is 0, and we want to figure out what b is going to turn out to be. So 1 times 0 gives me 0. I don't need to write that because 0 plus b gives me b. So here I have 1 is equal to b, and now I can write the equation for the tangent line, and that equation is going to be y is equal to, in this case, m is 1, so I don't need to write it. I can write the x plus b, where I found b to be 1. So the equation of the tangent line is y equals x plus 1. And now let's pull up the calculator to verify these answers. All right, I've gone ahead and I've already put in the functions here. E raised to the x is the original equation, and the equation for the tangent line, x plus 1. So let's go ahead and click on zoom and then click 6 to go to standard. Notice that the blue line is the original equation. The red line that we see, or about to come here, this red line here, is the equation for the tangent line. And this green box is the point of tangency, which we said was at 0, 1. Let's go ahead and zoom in to get a better look at this. So we'll click on zoom and then press 2 to zoom in. We want to zoom in at the origin. And here we are with a better close-up view. So again, that's our point 0, 1, the point of tangency, and our other two lines, well, our curve and then our linear equation. At this point, let's go ahead and verify that the slope is 1. So let's go to second and then trace. We want to go down to option 6, which gives us the derivative. And I want to find the derivative for the blue line, which is the original equation. And I need to find that when the x value is 0. And we see here it's already at 0, so I just press the enter key. And we see that that slope comes out to be approximately 1. Here we see we've got, it's a little bit over 1, but this is just basically the error that we see when using the calculator. The other thing to notice is that our point of tangency, when x is 0, we see that y is in fact 1. All right, that sums it up for this video by Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name. And as always, thank you for watching.